eles chegou a fazer dois. Aí eu disse assim, Deus, manda seu pai, o senhor manda alguma coisa assim, senhor, agora vem. But then he says, Allah has put in my heart that these two are both different things, Islam and what we see. So don't get it mixed up. And then I decided that since people were having some assumptions, and then people, some of the Muslims were concerned that, you know, I might cause a fitna between the Hindus and Muslims, because if somebody is from my place, he knows how communal that place is. But the truth is, if you have tawakkul on Allah, if you rely on Allah, nobody can do anything to you as long as Allah wills. And if somebody does something to you, always remember that Allah always wants good for you as long as you put the tawakkul on Allah. So, all those things I heard from Muslims, I know, some people find it shocking that how come nobody, nobody will question you? It is because it's Allah's will. And unless Allah wills, nobody has the right to even move their tongue. So, nobody actually came and asked me. I used to go, my neighbor was, active, the leader of the, RSS, or you see, Masjid Balaghat was in our place. So, I used to go to Masjid for Fajr and I used to see him on the way. But alhamdulillah, nothing can happen unless Allah wills. So, I knew that. Although some of the Muslims are saying, you need to, be careful and all that. So then I decided, maybe I need to seek more knowledge of the religion. So I need to move to a Muslim country, and alhamdulillah, some of the brothers, alhamdulillah, they helped me find a job. Actually, I'm 21 and I look much older right now. So I decided to give up my studies at that point of time, and I moved to Dubai, alhamdulillah. And it was a, I was very happy to see the number of masajids over here. I had come up with an expectation, but also I knew that these two are different things, so I didn't, get worried about all that. You have an opportunity of choosing the path over here. You want to go and see knowledge, you have the opportunity. You don't want to go, you have the other opportunity, so it's all up to you, alhamdulillah. So I was here, alhamdulillah, and the day I came here, for around 2-3 months, I think, I used to call my mom every single day. And most people assume that I must have given a dawah. No, I wasn't doing that. I was telling her, Mom, how are you? Mom, I miss you. I was telling her that, Mom, I love you. And if you are from a Hindu family, this is something like taboo, to tell your mom you love her, subhanAllah. This is something you wouldn't do. But I did that. Because this is what Islam asks you to do. And this, I remember one day, once he told my relatives that my son is so spoiled, I wish he was not born at all. And then Islam came to Allah, got into Islam, and I remember this day where she told me, son, I'm really proud of you. SubhanAllah. That was, that was the biggest blessing that Allah gave me. And so I used to speak to her every single day. I would speak to her, or maybe sometimes message her, but I'm missing her, I wish she was here, I wish she saw how Muslims are and how we live and all that. So it was more about being nice to her, because sometimes they say that no one will come in, somebody invite him for a cup of tea. No matter if you have all the proofs, and if you say that 1 + 1 = 2, if he doesn't like you, he's not going to accept what you say. And I knew that. So, since Allah has asked me to be nice to my mom, I was being nice to her, I was making dua to her. That is the one thing which most Muslims follow. They say that I want to give dua to. This is one question which I actually want to touch up here. This is one question, if there are any new Muslims over here, they often get this question. I have a Hindu colleague at work. How do I go into Islam? This is one question is very common, and maybe people ask me after the talk, I have a Hindu colleague, how do I go into Islam? I think you answer how do you go into Islam? And it's very simple. You need to do wudu properly. Now you might be thinking, what's wudu, what do you think becoming Muslim? The moment you do wudu properly, and the moment you stand in Salah, the moment you stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is your Lord, the moment you ask Him in your prayers, in your sujood, in the last part of the night, that, oh Allah, there is a colleague in me, oh Allah, my friend, he is working with me, and oh Allah, I'm telling him about Islam, oh Allah, mindset you go, you need to purify your intentions of why you want to guide your colleague to Islam. Is it because you want to see everybody go, you see, I even have he's my brother. Or do you actually want to do that because of the pleasure of Allah? Is it because of the pleasure, you know, attaining his pleasure, and that should be your sole intention for doing that. I hear so many people, I met somebody who was told me, how do you know this guy? And he tells, and I started speaking to him, I came to know this guy, he worships the graves, subhanAllah. And like, your house is on fire and you don't worship somebody else's house? I mean, how does that make sense? You are yourself committing the greatest of all shirk and you are asking, how do I guide somebody else to Tawheed? That's so fun. So, the first and foremost thing, if you want to give some dawah to somebody, I'm not saying that you need to perfect yourself and then go and give a dawah, no. But set your priorities right. What's your priority in life? Save yourself first from the hellfire and then your family. You can see so many brothers, you know, subhanAllah. They don't have the love for the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They don't. My father, Allah is going, and he's still sleeping. The Sunnah is going, he's still sleeping. And then they wake up in the morning, they go to the and they open the Bible and they start their dawah. SubhanAllah. You need to save yourself first, and then your family, and then you need to think about other people. Because if you go according to this way, SubhanAllah, you will get deviated. Today morning my Ustad, he told me that one thing which I see on the channel, that the scholars say that in your lifetime you need to make at least one person Muslim. You need to make at least one person Muslim. And you ask him who that one person is. That one person is you yourself. You need to make you yourself a Muslim first. And also according to the Hadith of Nawawi, which talks about what you need to do is do the faraid first and then the nawafil, and that's when Allah starts loving you, and that's when He accepts your du'as, and that's when He gives you refuge. So if you don't go according to this, and if you try to save the whole world by your will, while you yourself are destined to do, it's going to be a difficult journey for yourself. Okay, anyways, I think I lost the track. So, where was I? Yeah. I was talking to my mom, and then after a few months, I guess, what happened was, one Friday I was talking to her something, and then she said something, I don't remember exactly. The only reason why I don't remember many of the incidents is, I have not actually dreamt or thought that I'll be standing one fine day and talking to the Muslims about this story of how I came to Islam. I have not thought that this is what's going to be like the most important thing that happened to me in my life. But now I do realize, alhamdulillah, that she said something. I said, how come you're saying that you're not a Muslim? And she says, who do you that? I was like, she's going to be joking. Then I asked her, do you really want to become a Muslim? Because Islam, many people assume that, you know, people become Muslim out of force. There's no force in Islam, the Ayatollah of the Deen. So I asked her, do you want to become Muslim? And that's when she said, yes. I was actually flying in the air at that time, so I just couldn't believe what I heard. So I spoke to her. And I realized that she was doing her own research at that time, and she saw the changes in me. She saw that the son who was in the last track, who was hanging out with his friends, who was doing all the wrong stuff, has now come to the straight path. So, and she did her own research about whatever she thought, and alhamdulillah, she's in the audience right now, and I think she's listening. And alhamdulillah, that's when she took the shahada. The surprising part was, I spoke to my sister the same day, and that's when she also took the shahada. And she was 15 at that time, but then there was a very big test ahead for them. That was after a week of their becoming Muslims. I was here there. My dad passed away. Before he passed away, I went to speak to him maybe half an hour before his death. I just told him that he was at one God, because I can't explain to him, because in the last moment of the death, and he said, I believe in one God. I don't know if he said, don't ask me if you're Muslim, Allah to decide whether it's acceptable or not. Anyways, I fear that now since my dad has passed away, my mom and sister can think, you know, shaitan convinces them, and they can think that my was, I left my religion. Maybe I need to go back to my religion. So at this point of time, I decided that, alhamdulillah, they anyhow passed the test that Allah had for them, and alhamdulillah, they came over here, mashallah, they have more knowledge in that, being in the world, and mashallah, alhamdulillah. And this is how I came to Islam. And I think before I conclude, there's one last question that I would like to answer, which is one more very common question that people say. Like most people sitting over here, you must be having in mind that, mashallah, you know, this new Muslims and they're practicing, and it's very easy for them to practice, you know, subhanAllah. And just because they came to Islam, they lived something great, and that's where they know the value, and we are born Muslims and we can't go over this, and you know. Wallahi, this is the deception of the shayateen. It is up to you to follow the religion. It's not like we are new Muslims and that's why it's much more easy for us, or that's why we have the hope to know it is there. There are so many new Muslims who come into Islam and they're just the same. They just change their name, that's it. And there are so many Muslims who are born Muslims. Who are the ulama I give out of the century, like Sheikh Islam Rahimullah, Sheikh Albani Rahimullah, Sheikh Bibbaz Rahimullah, Sheikh Fawzan, Hafizahullah. They were all Muslims. Now, what has Satan done is he has made us, you know, sit laid back, and we find people type Shahada, words people, you know, we go to type Shahada, watch people meaning Shahadas, and this, we think we have done our job, our iman boosts, and we go back home, watch movies, go back to sleep, not wake up for further, go to work, lie, cheat, and do the same thing, go to YouTube, watch Shahada, and this is how we are, you know, brain fed by the Shayateen. So, Muslims, as Muslims, we need to realize that it's all up to us to come back to what Allah has asked us to do, and come back to the truth and live as a Muslim, not just be as a Muslim and claim to be a Muslim, live as a Muslim and die as a Muslim. I'm just complete, inshallah, that many Muslims assume that before they die, Hajj karega, it's going to happen like that, but it's not like that. Unless you live your life as a Muslim, those words before you die will not come out of your mouth. You will be singing, my hub, when you die, if you are not actually being Allah, ilaha illallah. So, if you want people to become Muslims, follow Islam, follow the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For example, this is just one example. Like, if you are, you know this surah over here, and there are lots of foreigners who come there. Imagine that every person working in that zone follows what Allah has told and lives his gaze when a strange woman walks in. What will the impression the foreigners will have in this place? You want to make your friend Muslim, your colleague Muslim. Imagine you are in a meeting and it's time for prayer and you get up and go pray. This will be a better dawah for him than you talking 24 hours about Christianity, Islam, and all the things that you are having. So, to conclude, I would like to thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to share my story. I hope that whatever I said today is of something that will benefit my akhirah first, and then the organizers, Al-Mahab Nursery Center, and then everyone who has been listening to this. Whatever was evil was from me and the Shayateen, and whatever was khair was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa akhiru Allah wa alhamdulillah wa rabbil alameen. Abdul
Rahman Romani was born in Romania to a Christian family of teachers. He moved to Canada in 1998. He left Christianity and began search for God soon. He accepted Islam in 2003. I call upon Brother Abdul Rahman. Assalamualaikum.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. I seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, most merciful, and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It was really dark outside,